songs. We are going to do, first of all, one that was collected from Ramsey. It's a little bit like There Wasn't a Woman Who Swallowed a Fly, but it's the Hop-tu-naa version. And then we're going to have a sing through the chorus of Creepy Folk Come Down. So that's just a few spooky oohs and ahs and some spooky whisperings for you as well. So we'll start with Hop-tu-naa, which is the Ramsey version. Are you ready?
Hop-tu-naa, Hop-tu-naa.
Ginny the witch, she ate the horse, she ate the maid and the tail, of course.
Hop-tu-naa, Hop-tu-naa.
Ginny the witch, she ate the cow, but how she ate the cow, I don't know how.
Hop-tu-naa, Hop-tu-naa.
Ginny the witch, she ate the sheep, she left the wool in the heap.
Hop-tu-naa, Hop-tu-naa.
Ginny the witch, she ate the horse, she ate the cat, and she ate the dog.
Hop-tu-naa, Hop-tu-naa.
Ginny the witch went into the house, she ate the ring, she ate the mouse.
Hop-tu-naa, Hop-tu-naa.
Ginny the witch, she'll see you soon, soon, and if you're not careful, she'll eat you too.
Hop-tu-naa, Hop-tu-naa.
Ginny the witch, she's in your house, just give us a belly, we'll chase her out.
Hop-tu-naa, Hop-tu-naa.
If you're gonna give us something, give us it soon, we'll want to be home by the light of the moon.
Hop-tu-naa, Hop-tu-naa.
Thank you.
and she lived about 300 years ago in a cottage with her 6 children.
Now, Joni was poor and she used to go around the neighbourhood begging for food. Sometimes the farmer's wife would give her something, but other times she was shooed away empty-handed.
Go away, you stupid old hag. Get out of here.
It was soon noticed, though, that her bad luck often fell on those who had refused her. The cow's milk would dry up. The horse would go lame. The hens wouldn't lay their eggs. And Joni got the blame. But Joni was also known for doing good deeds.
Once, a farmer and his wife came to her in desperation.
Please help us, the doctor said. There's nothing they can do.
Joni tended to the child that night, and the next morning he was right as rain. He lived to a ripe old age, married and had 12 children. With each charm, curse and cure, Joni's reputation as a witch grew more and more.
One dark and stormy night.
Was in need of shelter.
He walked, searching through the wind and rain, and came across Joni's cottage, a dim light flickering in the window. Half hoping for no answer, he gave 3 timorous knocks. The door creaked open, and there stood Joni.
You can rest here, but you must sleep with your face to the wall.
The traveller climbed into his bed. There's the soft snoring of the 6 children and the mewing of the cat.
As the traveller drifted off, he saw strange shadows on the wall. Was that Joni stepping into a big basket? The door opened with a whoosh. The basket flew out of the cottage, carrying Joni away.
Oh, I'm dreaming.
He slept soundly till dawn. When the door creaked open again, Joni returned with another whoosh. Stepping out of the basket as the traveller watched, carrying fresh herring and vegetables.
Joni's reputation as a witch, able to get her own way by magic, began to spread throughout the neighbourhood, as she seemed to enjoy her fame. Another traveller spoke of how she was returning home one night and seemed to sense someone's presence.
Hello, is anybody there?
Yes, it is I, the good witch.
But Joni took it a step too far when she upset one of the most powerful men on the island. She went to the Bishop's Mill, where William Corrin,
the Bishop's Miller,
was handing out sacks of flour to the poor.
Joni has gone along for her share, but when she saw the poor quality of the grain being used, she rebukes the miller in front of the large
stood triumph before Bishop Wilson and his clergyman, who found her guilty.
Guilty. 14 days in Peel Castle. And a fine of £3. Then you will stand at Market Cross.
Now, the punishment might sound harsh, but Journey actually got off very lightly. If she had lived in England or Scotland, rather than the Isle of Man, she could have been hanged or burned at the stake.
Ooh. After her release, she returned home. And as far as we know, Joni Lowney lived quietly ever after.
So we're just going to have a sing of the first four verses of Hop-tu-naa in Manx to show you how to Hop-tu-naa. So if you know the chorus, feel free to join in. You can join in with us. And we're going to sing the four verses for you. You ready? No, geez. Okay.
To show me how to hop you in, to lift me so much of tra-la-la.
Dance, which you probably all know, you know, make an arch, go and down, make an arch, go and down, make an arch, go and down, turn away and go back home. So we thought we'd tie them in knots for this one. So this is Hop-tu-naa.
Hop-tu-naa, tra-la-lay, Ginny the witch flew over the house to fetch a stick to lather the mass. Hop-tu-naa.